Okay, we're over here in Manchester at Ricky Hatton's gym, and we've got the Southern boys up for the day.
But no, it's all good up here. I mean, we love coming up here. Ricky's so hospitable to us, you know. I mean, let's come up here. Obviously, you've seen a bit of sparring with Mike today. Ben's sparring a bit later. I mean, it's great. I mean, I love it up here. I wish, to be honest with you, I wish we could come up here 5 days a week, go back to weekends, because I get so much more out of them, because it's more concentrated here, you know. So, but it's great. It's, you know, brilliant gym, great atmosphere, and it's sort of like a gym that just breeds winners, you know. And it's, I think that's what we're trying to instill into these two, that that's what I want, you know. And it's, you know, and I'm still picking things up. I'm far from a great, a good trainer even, but I might pick a bit off of Ricky and that. Even Matthew was here today. It's great, you know. I mean, I'm still nicking things off of everyone, you know. So it's great for us. I mean, the boys love coming out. We feel quite privileged to be to be up here, you know. And it's like, you know, Ricky and obviously Mike Jackson's a big help with us, and then there's Blaine. I mean, always, you know, always pointing things out to us, which is great. So
I mean, you know, Manchester is there's quite a lot of gyms up here. It's like thriving boxing. What is it like down the south? Do the lads go around to all of the gyms there? Do you have that camaraderie there?
I mean, I love it. I mean, Alan Smith, he's got a great gym. I think it was at iBox, isn't it? Yeah, they've got some great boys there. Dan Carr, what's his name? Richard, what's it? Richard, the sniper.
Lerone Richards,
things like that. Some good boys there. Obviously, Bradley Skeet, people down there spar with. And we were quite lucky down there, but I just, in summer, I like to get away from the area, if you know what I mean. Not it's a problem for us, but I just want to get away. Again, we're quite lucky. I'm lucky enough where I'm close enough to say Ricky's my friend, and even we've, you know, started taking over Joe Gallagher's gym, you know, who's sparring with Paul Butler the other week, which is great. And I just don't want them to be, get a bit complacent staying in one gym. I want them to be ready to rock and roll. Anytime we get a phone call, look, they're sparring up road, let's get in the car. And you know, I wouldn't say it ain't a break for us, but it's nice to get out the area. Yeah, we're staying in a hotel for the night. It's great. I mean, you know, we ain't got no money, but if we'll club in together, all three of us stick a little bit of money in, and we'll get by, you know. I think this is where they're getting their experience from, rather than, you know, now it's coming to the end of the season. I want them training even harder now. It ain't like it's break time, because a lot of fighters out, they only train when they got fights. This is where they're learning now. When they won't fight till the end of September, but this is where, especially with Ben. I mean, Mike as well. Mike's only had four. I mean, pro wise, had 14. Yeah. I mean, it sounds like a lot, but he's only been boxing like 3 or 4 years. Yeah. It's nothing, you know. And so that's where. Sounds like a lot of fights, but he ain't really, because he's learning every day. And same with Mikey, you know. I'm just trying to work them together, and it's good that way.
Yeah. It's nice to come up here, Boy Jones Jr. here.
It's always Ricky to come up here. As I said at the start of the career, Ricky's always been my idol, so it's always nice to like share the gym with him and that. Yeah. And when he takes me on the pads, it's a bit surreal for me.
You suffered a loss a couple of fights back, but you're straight back in there. You know, you've a really promising career in the super featherweights, and you've been coming on really well. I know you had that loss, but
a loss, it was a learning curve.
It was a learning curve, and it was nice to see that you were straight back in there as well.
Yeah, no, listen, to be honest, I'm glad I lost, because it just showed what we had, and I can compete at that level as well. Mm. So it's we're coming back from it, we're not coming back from it, because we didn't go nowhere. Mm. But it's good that we lost, because it just shows that.
The only thing, but also what it's shown us really is that how fickle this sport is.
Yeah.
Where before it was like, you know, the sun shone out of his backside in a way, which I didn't really want in the foot. I wanted to go on a low, but we were doing so well, he got out, taking out my hands a little bit. Now all of a sudden, there ain't no phone call, like, no one wants to do this with, no one wants to do that. Everyone else is getting the slots over him, which I don't think is right. But then I just say, look, we'll see you in the long grass. This is the master plan for him, and Mike as well. We get back grassroots. We love boxing on them small shows. There, I think there's a small show. Wham Promotions got a small show in September the
21st.
Prince Regent's, hopefully, not been confirmed yet. They're both going to be on it. And I'm let's go grassroots. Yeah. That's where we started, and that's where we're going to finish.
Yeah.
I mean, but what annoys me is that all of a sudden, because he had a loss, which was, I don't, you know, there's certain things I have to hold responsible for. But in the, I just think, obviously we had the loss, all of a sudden he gets dropped from this, dropped from that. This is an hard sport. Mm. If you can't look at the weekend, there's some good fighters got beaten the weekend, not naming no names, but they come back. Mm. This is what it's all about. It's really? Like, all of a sudden it's...
Not everyone's Mayweather.
No, exactly. You know, these
only
got,
been one Mayweather.
Yeah, but these have got to learn on the run. You know, I mean, these are learning as they're working. So also we've got to have a few hiccups. Why should that from day one? But then all of a sudden, oh, there ain't no interviews. There ain't no this. And I said, good, get on with it. We're sharp, especially when he's winning titles and defending titles. And we might, Mike's going to be the same. And then we're going to be going, okay. And then they come to us and they say, where were you like 2 years ago after he's lost his fight? Yeah. And there's magazines out there you read, they're all these same people in it. So what? They don't deserve to be in magazines. And it is, it gets my goat a little bit, as you can tell. But no, it's just like, I mean, we're the hard-working boys, they don't get it. I mean, don't you? I said, we had a good run. I particularly, as I said to them, I didn't want that, I wanted to go on the low. But we obviously, things overtook us a little bit, but then it's great. I said, okay, let's go do what we're doing. And then once we do get the title, and then I said, let's just be ready, because that's what they do, they drop it on you, they're going to go bang, there's a title, but you've got to take 3 weeks, no problem. I mean, he's only about 4 or 5 pounds overweight now from 9.4, so it's great for us, you know.
Always,
I mean,
in the gym.
Yeah, always. I mean, this is where they're both learning now, you know. I mean, well, I'm quite lucky that Mike's come back. I mean, he had great training before with Peter Sims. I mean, they're just doing their own thing at the moment. I think with Peter, what is Peter so busy? So, but in, like Peter's let come to us now again, and it's great for us, you know. I mean, it's just, you know, we had him from at the beginning, so it ain't nothing new. It's just, you know, what do you say, the thing
is, prodigal son's return.
Prodigal son's return, you know what I mean? Yeah. But that's great, and these two get on well, you know, they grew up together, so it's great. And I don't, you know, I've shut my shop down a little bit. These are the only two pro fighters I've got, because the others don't give me what I want. And the one thing I want out of boat, when I said, oh, I will fight for you, and you know I'm with the boys, but I just want a bit of loyalty. This place, this sport is offering, it's full of dogs, you know what I mean? And this ain't a loyal sport. And it is, and we could, there's a great word out there, and it will come around for us. It's called karma. And karma's a bitch, ain't it? And it is, it's great for me, because I'm gonna sit back, these two boys do exactly what I tell them. And I said, then when, if it does something, goes, well, then you can blame me. Blame me, I don't, because then, but if you do it your way and you mess up, don't be blamed, you've got to blame yourself. But at least do it my way, and then you've got someone to blame then, ain't there, sir? But again, I'm just quite fortunate. We've only been up here, they've had such a good life already. They've been sparring later, we've got, you know, a couple of days here, it's going to be great for them. And it's great, I think it's a brilliant experience for the pair of them. Not me, is it? It's for them, so.
That was a good spike there. Mike Saki, you say you've had four pro fights now?
Yeah, 4, 3 and 1.
Yeah, it's a nice spot today there with Adam Ake. How did you find that?
I really enjoyed it, actually. I was, to be fair, I was quite nervous coming because I haven't sparred properly since.
That's his first spar with me. That's since he's come back.
He was like, you're gonna do 6 today, and I was, oh bloody hell, I'm not sure if I'm gonna be able to do the 6. But I got in there, and like, after the 4th round, I felt fresh still. So
it was really nice.
It's the best I've seen him.
Looked really confident and more seasoned than someone who's had 4 fights. I must say.
Yeah, I mean, what I've tried to do, I mean, all the track work. We do a lot of track work, 3 times a week track. And 3 times to do the long ones, but then obviously coming near fight time, it goes the other way. Normally does 4 track, 2 long runs. You know what I mean? Now, I don't think you can beat the track work to get the stamina up. Stamina's such a big thing in this game. I mean, I'll just say, I think he's got all the tools in the box, but I just don't think he's fit. He's never had the fitness or the confidence in his fitness to believe he can carry it off for 6, 8,
well,
or 10 rounds.
Well, if you keep doing them 4-minute laps, so you'll get...
Oh, yeah. I didn't want to say that. You broke your leg or something, you know what I mean? I thought you were a snail that got chucked out of his house. But it's quite
tortoise
a joke.
In the hair, isn't it?
Have you seen an airy tortoise? But no, they're brilliant. That's what I'm saying. They keep me going. So that's, you know, like Ricky was saying to you earlier about... his gyms, the boys are, you know, he's doing the things with his boys, and they're his boys, and they're keeping him on the straight and narrow. 1,000,000% with these two, they do the same. Because all I said, all I want is a bit of loyalty, you know, and it's, you know, I'm here, I ain't going nowhere, but my loyalty, I'm like that with people. So some people like it, some people don't. At least nobody stand with us.
So. How have you found the pro ranks, Mike?
I love it. I think I've always had more of a pro style than anything else, but like Dom says, it's with me, it's all about believing in my fitness and believing in my ability, believing in myself, and then once that clicks, I reckon there's no limit to what we can do, to be honest.
Believe it or not, and I know I'm really good, I know I'm like one of the best in all, I'll take it, but he bashes me up. I get scared of him.
No, it's good when they spar. I mean, they spar together years, and sometimes I don't like them sparring, because we get a bit, because Mikey Kent, he's got a bit of a bang on him. Sometimes we forget he's only 9 stone 5, 9, 6, and even though he's 9 or 10 2 or 10 3 box, he box for 12 to 10 stone. The kid can bang. He's very sharp. He's dangerous sometimes. You forget that. Also, again, he's still a kid and he's a man.
Yeah.
You know, you can tell by the whiskers on his chin. He stuck them in earlier. You know what I mean?
The great name of it by Jones. I mean, we're probably old enough to remember when a loss coming through was exactly what you said. It's a learning curve.
Yeah, a loss can make a man. Yeah. Like sometimes you've got to fall down to get rise up taller.
Yeah. I think there's a bit more emphasis.
You like that one? I read that one the other day.
A bit more emphasis these days on an unbeaten record. And I mean, if there's no substance behind it, it doesn't matter. So fair play to
everyone. Everyone wants to go on the Mayweather route, but we want to go a different way.
I mean, listen, we not going to go, like, I know Craig Poxon, he's fighting, defending his title on the 27th. We're going to be there. Because that's what we're looking for. That is the fight we want.
See you later, mate. Take care.
But we want him, as he said, I think the only way we can put things right is if we put it straight.
Yeah.
Because all some people say, and I just think, I really rate Pox and always have done, and that's why I'm going to fight come. I knew it was going to be that hard. But from that fight then to that, he's changed already.
Yeah.
He's we worked on certain things that, that we see weaknesses in him. That we're gonna correct it, and I don't think we've Craig, and it's not being disrespectful. No, he will not get any better than what he is. I think he's hit his peak now, And right, way he boxed Ben was way he boxed George Jupp, way he boxed. I mean, I watched all these fights, and nothing changed. My problem there was the fact, if I'm being honest, and I wasn't in the corner with him, and that's why we changed. I've got my license sorted out. I've had to, apologise to a few people, put a few things right, but now we're back on. We're on board now. I'm not saying. People say, well, do you think if you were in the corner, he would have won? If I was in the corner, because certain things we worked on for three months solid, and even after the fight, we sit there. They won't sit there. We're all upset. We sit there. We spoke about the fight. We dissect it, and he goes, "What you told me about Craig was exactly what he done." And I said, but you not being in the corner trying to refresh his memory, because sometimes you do get...
It's a familiar voice.
He got caught up, and it was like, certain things he'd done. He goes, but Dom, you were so wrong when he'd done this, he'd done that, and I just didn't remember what you told me and things like that. So that's why I have to stand and perhaps take half the blame for the loss as well as him. I mean, but, in my eyes, okay, well, he lost the fight to Craig. Craig's a great fighter. Mm. But then I don't think the way he's not been treated, but all of a sudden he's in his eyes, there ain't been no interviews with him. Not that we want interviews, but people forget he's still a kid.
Mm.
He's had bloody 18 fights all his life. Mm. We were speaking here today about a lad that I think might be coming to Ricky. He's had about 300 amateur or 175 amateur fights. Oh, my God. In my program, a nice crowd about 100 fights. I mean, that's it. This kid's still learning. That's why I want him busy. That's why I want him coming to the gyms. And same as Mike, let's make our mistakes here.
Yeah.
And then when he fight, and I said, when we fight in September, bang, we'll be like, I'm ready a new car. This is the boy Jones Jr.
Yeah.
This is be the boy, nearly a man Jones Jr. Yeah. Well, he's still got a couple of years yet.
It's your apprenticeship, isn't it? And if there's no ups and downs in the apprenticeship, then when you do step up to the real thing,
and when stuff happens, you don't know how to deal with it. But it's good to have these experiences now. And not later on in my career.
I've got to say a massive thanks to Andy Ayling, because without him, obviously, he's his manager, and obviously Jason McCrory, he's taken Mike on force, which is good. Then we've got the sponsors, we've got H Group,
Acorn Insurance,
T1 Co.
Pro Money,
always Pro Money. Who else is there?
12 by 75.
They're the best ones, aren't they? Because they sell wine, don't they?
Yeah, they sell
wine. I like wine. Who else is there? Come on. LB and Peter?
Pete and LB for brilliant. Everything they do.
Brilliant.
For.
And what about the other one? Oh, you said Acorn, didn't you?
Not focusing on the loss. You've had a good learning career as well, haven't you? And you have impressed in your fights. And
I think every fight, even the loss, I've got better and better. Yeah. It's not been a roller coaster when I've gone and done a bad performance, good performance, bad performance. I think every fight I've been showing everyone that I've been learning and adapting to different styles and different type of fighters.
Yeah. I mean, it's like when you look at the opponents the weekend that got beaten by certain fighters at his weight or above. The only people that he's beaten already, and all of a sudden they might stop him a bit quicker, but unless he boxed them and see, they would never pick them opponents anyway, because you look at him and go, so this guy's ain't bad, actually. Look at his record. And then, same because we go and do our own work, that's what annoys me. There's these boys that then, okay, they might have got them out of the way a little bit quicker, but again, they forget, hey, they're more experienced, not so much younger, but they're more experienced, a lot more experienced than him, and some are a lot older, you know what I mean? It's like, okay, so, and I said it to him, don't be despondent at the fact that, oh, he's boxing, I'll beat him, and I said, but it doesn't matter, but they wouldn't have fought them kids unless, because they wouldn't have known what they were about, you know? Mm. I mean, it is, again, I'm not being bitter or anything, I realise, from first-hand experience, what an hard sport this is, and what a unloyal sport this is, because one minute you're flavour of the week, and the next minute you, well, we're so-and-so, oh, I'll phone him later, you know, I mean, it ain't that, it should be, should it, you know, but I'm afraid this is the sport we're in, so.
Yourself, Mike, you know, your career, the four fights, you just sort of explain, you know, how you've, feel you've performed in them, and just, you know, about the loss, and similar to Boyer, you know, was it a similar kind of learning curve for you?
Yeah, the loss was, honestly, after I, like, woke up the next day, it's like I knew everything that I had to do for that not to happen again. And I think that's a blessing in disguise kind of thing. Like Ben was saying, it's not really a loss, it's a learning curve. And I didn't lose to someone that was a journeyman that was coming to get his check and go. It was a 50-50 fight and he was just a better man on the night. So I think it's something, a fight I would want again down the line.
That'd be there, honestly, you know, yeah. We can get there, it's not.
But
I've
definitely learned a lot from it and know where I need to improve. Yeah. So, yeah, it's just a blessing in disguise, really.
See, we're quite lucky as a team. I mean, obviously, like, we talk together and we sat there and have done this. I said, what do you want to do? What do you? So he might fire off of him and I said, well, okay, we're trying it. But even when we were doing pads and stuff, they might go, Dom, let's try this one. Let's try, because I'm always open for suggestions. You know what I mean? If it feels right, let's try it. You know what I mean? What do you think you're lacking? Like, you know, I told him I think he lacks his fitness, and then he always has been like that from day dot since we knew him. But that's something we can, I mean, as you can see, he's a very stylish fighter. He's got all the tools. But you just got to be fit enough to be able to do that at a pace for 12 rounds, isn't it? It's no good if you're like good for one round, and all of a sudden you're gonna, if that my fight and I might go, stick it on him for a round or two, and you'll break him up. Mm. You know, and that's it, take, because he's very sharp and he can punch. Yeah. So be tight, be close, you know, be careful the first couple of rounds, and then you'll start grinding him down. Mm. So, but we've got to get out of that, because I want, as you see there, for the first round, two, three, then four, six rounds, he was on tight, and he was nice and tight, and he's nice and loose. And it is coming. This, I'm not saying Rome, you know, Rome won't built in a day, but let's enjoy it while we're doing it. Yeah. You know, because it's hard, like new guys, and you know, it's like you probably had a job you didn't want to go to. This is their jobs now. Yeah. You know, and it comes a time when it's going to be the end of it. And when you wake up in the morning, think, oh, I don't want to go to work, that's the time to say, especially this. Yeah. Yeah, well, this is the time to say, you've got to stop, because you know, some people like it, some people don't. I mean, it's, you know, but I've got great hopes for the pair of them, and I mean, I'm just saying it. I mean, so again, with the help of Ricky, and he's saying something with Joe's place, and again, I'm always open for suggestions for training and sparring, because you never hear me say, I'm a great trainer, I'm just at the bottom, but I'm picking bits off of everybody.
I think the good thing about us three, we're all still learning, and that's why we adapt to each other.
It's nice that you're coming through like that together. Starting with you, mate, what's next for you, and how do you see sort of the next year panning out?
To Dom, really, I'd say. What we'll do, we'll get September out of the way.
Get some good wins under my belt.
And work on what we've been working on. Yeah. And once we're confident in that, then we can start pushing on for names.
So I'm confident in his abilities, just his stamina lets him down at the moment, which ain't a problem, because we know, we did something now. And he said, I said, but you know the problem? Yeah, then we can fix it.
Yeah.
Many people that don't understand, oh, no, I don't get it, I don't, you know, that's when you've got a problem. But he ain't listening. He said, well, he's got to take about 3 weeks, take a month to get his stamina up, right, we all train. Yeah. And that's not a problem.
If you have something, you can work on that.
Yeah, no, of course, everyone can, you know. So.
Absolutely. Yeah. And yourself, what?
That's the same thing as.
Have you got any dates set?
I think it's the 21st of September.
Yeah. We're hoping. Hoping on WAM Promotions, Prince Regent's, and in our Chigwell and Essex. Hopefully that is. It's not been confirmed, but I've got a phone call today. Small show. It'd be great. Just want to get them back on. You know, they need to be fighting, both of them. You know, they need to be fighting, learning their trade. You know, and then hopefully after Christmas, or, you know, hopefully we get obviously titles like. He get an area title. He's already had the area title, but I mean, obviously, Craig's out, and obviously that's one thing that I know he wants to put right, and I want to put right. Yeah. You know, I mean, which, you know, that was already one of the fights of the year. I think, you know, that and the first Jermaine Smythe and Dale Williams fight. Williams fight. They're both they're contenders for fights of the year. I mean, but I mean that's one we need to put right. If we put that one right, then his stock goes back up to where it was. Mm. But I mean, it's, I think it's a fight Craig could have anyway. It'd be a better money fight than some of the fights he's probably been offered. Yeah. But listen, let's just see what happens. And again, let's get September out of the way. I mean, he's had two good wins anyway. I mean, all right, he had a good win, a six-round points win, which is exactly how I wanted him to box.
Yeah.
And then you stop the kid in the first round, which, you know, we can only fight what we put in front of us. You know, everyone's going, oh, I said, it doesn't matter. You know what I mean? Don't, anybody's got a problem, don't say it to him, say it to me, because it's down to me. And 90% of the decisions are down to me. So same thing with Mike, you know what I mean? It's, there's a problem, then come and see me, you know what I mean? But, you know, some people are so, this media log is such a joke where everyone say what they want but they are behind a bloody computer screen. Because walking to the pub and saying to me, you ain't going to say it to my face, are you? I mean, but I don't even mean it like that. I sound a bit muggy there, but nine times it's what you're, well, type that then. You never come back, you ain't going to come back bite me in the bum, is it? But no, that's how it is. So. But now we're looking forward to a good new season.
Yeah,
so.
There's a long way to go and you're doing it the right way by the sounds of it and you're getting on that.
Yeah, I think that's one of the things with a lot of fighters nowadays, like on the bigger shows, you see them being pushed so fast. Yeah. Everyone's, like even myself, I find myself thinking, I need to catch up. But it's not a sprint, it's a marathon.
Marathon,
you need to make sure
longevity.
You're secure in your style, in your way you're fighting, before you can even start thinking about people.
It's what I'm trying, and the plus of the way I find is really if you notice him, he can be very crisp, but quite a good counterpuncher. He's just, I don't want to get in it. I don't want to get in coming. I mean, my way of fighting was just come, I'll take a punch, get a punch. And I don't want him fighting like that. As if you know, I'll try and quite work on the defences. I want him, you know, he's got a little baby Rio, you know what I mean? He's got his girl Carla indoors, you know, he's got Jazz indoors, he ain't got kids yet.
No.
Don't want to leave.
I've got two dogs.
That'll do.
Two puppies.
But listen, like in 10 years, 15 years time when the careers are over and they're all sitting there, and they're all white, not sitting there. And I'll sit there sometimes, I think, oh, no, I had an odd career sometimes, because I'll sit there and think, oh, that don't feel right. No. But it's a sport we've chosen, but let's do it the right way. So all I know as a trainer, what I needed now as a professional fighter. Well, I let my, not let myself down, but what I didn't realise, what I needed then is what I know these boys need now. So that's why I say, dudes, I tell you, because I know that's where I was going wrong, you know, with my fitness and things like that. Just don't cut corners and you'll be all right, so.
I mean, you know, it's there's a long way to go in your careers, but when you do finish, there's a long way to go in life. So
yeah,
you can fit everything in.
What did Mickey say
the
other day about your career?
Make the sacrifices now.
Just every moment of it, enjoy it.
It's because it's over too soon, you know what I mean? That's just saying, enjoy it. Like enjoying them people you meet. That's why I'll take them out. Yeah. I want to meet all new people. Yeah. I don't want to. We ain't going to be boxing out of one little gym where you can't train with Dole. Don't get in, man. I want to meet. Well, listen, if they do go and train with other people, I can't help that. Can I? That's there. They're going to do it anyway, ain't they? But I don't want it. Then, you know, I don't want to think we can only, like, we only, you know, we don't go out this gym. Listen, they're going, how lucky we to be here.
Yeah.
And I said, last week we had, like, Joe Gallagher's in Mere Khan place in Bolton. How lucky are we? Yeah. You know, it's amazing. Now, I wish I had it when I was a pro. That's why I'm willing to sacrifice my kind of life, if you want, to do. These boys would do better than me because I was too much of a bloody big idiot, you know what I mean? I was, you know what I mean? That's.
But you can look back in hindsight and pass on that.
Yeah, of course, I was too busy trying to be an idiot. That's what I call it, an idiot. I was just a bit of an idiot back in the day. And it is, these ain't nothing like me. These are nice boys, you know what I mean? So, and they're good kids, you know what I mean? And it's nice. And I've got to keep stop saying, you know what I mean?
Just keep saying that. You know what I mean?
Dom, 15 years since you last fought. Was it Audley Harrison your last fight?
Ordinary. Well, officially, yeah.
Your life's good for you, though, as a coach. Now, are you getting that fulfilment in your life? What
I am
now.
Do you know, if I'm being honest, we've had a bit of a mad couple of years. And it's just the last few months, I had a right old sieve out. With fighters and stuff, and just doing it my way. Just gone. I've got me license now, so I've gone out and I had some other fighters, but due to it doesn't matter. But due to lack of understanding, perhaps on my behalf and their behalf, whatever. But I like things my way. That, you know, I'm down to two professional fighters, and I'm more than happy. You know what I mean? Because they know what I give them. No one else will give them that. I mean, I'm out. I'll graft with them. Do whatever I've got to do with them. But yeah, I mean, like even life itself isn't too bad. I mean, you know, the bit of an ups and downs with my old woman. That looks quite good now. We're sorting things. You know, day at time. You know, as much as all the crap I've been through the last few years, I've got to give her a due. She's she's always been there for us. She wouldn't back, wouldn't have no one say anything about us, which is the loyalty thing. And I've got a great daughter, she's 13 years old, and she's made me a better man. She really has. You know, at one point I wasn't a nice person, you know, back 13 years, 14 years ago. Not saying I was the art, not being art, but I just wasn't a nice bit ignorant, be like that. So she opened my eyes a little bit. She made me realise. So the last couple of years have been a bit funny. Obviously, like I just did my own thing last couple of years, and I've gone back to Sparta gym with my partner, our partner Ian Wilson, and that's where we're back there training there, which is basically where we started from in the beginning.
Yeah. Right, it's a bash Mount Mikey up.
But yeah, things have changed a little bit. I mean, Ian's great. I mean, Ian just wants to get on. And, you know, he said, Dom, he said, this is your gym. He said, we all started together. He goes, we have such a laugh in there, though. I mean, we have some good people in there. I mean, it's great. And he's going, it's only around the corner where they live, so it's great for him. But it's, you know, sometimes you have to make a few mistakes to realise where you've gone wrong. Yeah. And someone doesn't, as a grown man of 46, going on 47 in 2 weeks' time, to say sorry, it's quite humbling. You know, I realise it doesn't hurt to say sorry, especially if you know you're wrong. Mm-hmm. But there's so many people out there that they just want to, they ain't like me. And probably it's a good thing, really, but it's just, you know. Again, it's just, you know, I've got my little family, I've got the boys, I've got like the gym, got Ian, things like that, and you start realising who want to help you. And, you know, again, I keep saying, again, without Andy Aileen, with him, and now Jason McCoy with him, you know, we would have been stuck a little bit, because when I took him to Andy, no one knew him, it was this kid, rubbish, things like that. And all of a sudden, when Andy came up, he goes, I ain't a good kid, ain't he? I said, but he doesn't know nothing. He said, well, we're going to do it this way, slowly, slowly, and that's what we've done. Yeah. You know, in some ways, perhaps we shouldn't have had the title fight, really, but that was supposed to be a little gift for him, and he done it, and we should have really given it up and gone back to scratch again. But it was, so perhaps we all got lost a little bit in the hoo-ha of it all, because we all know how good he is. Yeah. And that, but, you know, but that's saying, that's what I'm saying, perhaps you all learned a little lesson that night.
It's been really great to see you and catch up with you, and obviously it's the first time we've ever done an interview, isn't it?
Well you want to come to Sparta? You want to come down? You come and meet everyone there. I mean, we have all sorts in there, like football players, this and that. Yeah. You know, Nathan Massey, who won, what's it called? Love Island last year. He's always in there. Yeah. You know, but he was there from another one today. You've got Ross Pearce, he's there.
Yeah, Italian.
What's his name? Elliot. Elliot Wright, yeah. We train him for his football. I did my friend of mine. Yeah. But yeah, when they come in, I mean, they train. They don't, you know, no one come and train to fight. Anybody can come in here. You pay your money, you come and pay. You know, but we're quite lucky there. I mean, it's like the gym. Believe it or not, you walk in there. We don't suffer fools gladly. If you don't, you won't think you got to go, and that's that. And it ain't that. I mean, it's just the atmosphere. Is it? You'll find a lot of gyms. You'll have people coming in. They don't get on. Ricky wouldn't have them in here. It's just how it is, isn't it? Everyone works as a team. You see. So
where's the gym, Dom?
Chingford. Right next to Chingford Rugby Club next door. It's called Team Sparta. Come, you pay £7 a day, come and have a go.
Well, we're going to get on the road a bit, aren't we? So we'll come
down
and see.
That'd be great. Listen, you just tell me we'll be there. Got a nice coffee shop. It was the secret coffee shop, it's called.
Is that what it's called?
Dave Dent. Yeah, David Dent's got it.
Banging smoothies.
Best smoothies. Don't laugh. I've started this vegetable diet, like juice diet. I know I've lost a couple of bounties, but nothing about that. I lost a tenner earlier, just flat my pocket. But
now cheap, buddy, them.
No, but he does all the boys, he's mad, vegetable smoothies, unbelievable. Yeah. Brilliant it is. And it, you know, it's called, was it the secret coffee shop?
That's us on the doorstep.
Yeah, right next door. What is your company there?
Well, there's a McDonald's, it's up to you.
Yeah, don't you blaspheme.
I'll join you in the McDonald's.
I enough of that. Right.
Happy meal, yeah.
Yeah, kids meal, but he gets a toy. But no, anytime you want to pop me, you're more than welcome,
I appreciate that. Absolutely.
No, brilliant. Yeah. We appreciate your time, so it's nice.
Well, God bless you all and rest of your careers. You know, wish you all the very best of luck and definitely catch up again soon.
Yeah, thank you. Brilliant.
Okay, guys.